yo, my vida, boss little. Call me when I'm feeling sick. Call me when I'm feeling down. Call me when you need someone to talk.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is actually going to be skincare, my hair, my makeup, and my outfit. A very casual spring inspired look. I have a lunch date today with a friend at 3 p.m. So what time is it right now? It's currently 11:30 a.m. So I should be ready by then. If I sound a little off in this video, I've been sick. You know, I'm just getting better. I have a flu. Oh, happy new year. Oh, wait. Are we still doing happy new year? How is 2020 be going for you? We are in March. Like, I don't even know how we got here. We're actually getting into spring season. The sun is coming out. I'm about to be glowing in the sun. Oh my god.
Oh my god. Wow.
I miss the sun already. Like, I can't wait. I'm tired of wearing winter coats. I'm tired of wearing jackets. But anyways, let's get started. So I'm starting off with my skincare, like I mentioned. I actually just got off the shower, so my face is dry. I haven't put anything at all on my skin. It's just like naked. The green tea to be blend detox max. This is what I'm going to start off with. It actually has clay in it, personalized clay and other kinds of clay, and it also has vitamin E. If you guys didn't know, clay is actually really good for your skin, especially for those of us that have oily skin like myself. It helps to cleanse your pores, take out all the impurities, detoxify your entire pores, any clogging you have in your pores. I'm actually partnering up with them today. Thanks to you guys and thanks to them. The package also came with this brush applicator for the mask. I just got off the shower, so my skin is very bare. I haven't done anything yet to my face. Apply this mask on my skin. Ooh, feels so cool. It smells like green tea, literally. You know one thing I find so therapeutic? Literally applying face mask, especially when it's a colored one. Okay, so it actually says that we're supposed to leave this mask on our face for about 10 to 15 minutes for it to dry down. Where is it right now? 12:58. So I'm going to leave it on my face for 10 to 15 minutes for it to dry down.
1 eternity later.
Apparently it's been 15 minutes later. I can barely remove my mouth because my face feels stiff. But you guys can see the mask is pretty much dry. I'm just going to go right now to wash off my face and I'll be right back. Washed up the mask, you guys. My face feels so soft. It just feels clear and it feels so soft. It feels so good. It feels squeaky clean. Right now, I'm going to go ahead and put on my day serum, which is a drunk elephant vitamin C serum. I'm going to go ahead right now to use the TEAMI blend tea infused oil. It has chamomile flower inside it. Can you guys see the chamomile flower? The fact that you actually have oily skin doesn't mean you shouldn't use moisturizer, because sometimes your skin tends to get oily because of lack of moisture. Your body's just telling you, hey girl, I need some oil, moisturize me, kind of thing. So right now I'm going to go ahead to use only 2 drops of this, because like I mentioned, I have oily skin. So I'm not going to use too much. However, I'm still going to moisturize my skin. So I'll just use only 2 drops of this. And this oil is actually perfect because it's lightweight, so it's not too thick. It's not going to clog my pores. Oh my God, it actually smells so good. I like the glow that I'm getting. Like, it's not like I'm shining, it's just like I'm glowing. And last thing I normally do as of lately to finish up my skincare. Okay, wait, before I actually show you guys what I actually do, I need to tell you guys this quick story. So for the past, let's say literally my entire life, how old am I now, 22, right? I've always thought that I had like hyperpigmentation on my neck as a result of sunburn. Up until recently, this winter season, hey God. One morning, I just woke up feeling very cute and I dressed up, put on my jewelry, you know, looking all good. I was like, okay, I'm not going to wear choker today. I'm going to actually wear my chain necklace. I had to wear the necklace for like up to 2 hours. My whole neck was itching. Like, it was literally just itching me. And I always had like rashes around my neck area. But bear in mind, I never actually paid attention to like the entire rashes and the entire, you know, itchiness and whatever. I never paid attention to it. To me, I just felt like, oh gosh, my body's itching me. Oh my God, why is my body itching me? Itching me. So I bought a lot of drawers for Fashion Nova. So every day I'll be changing. I feel like I want hot girl. So that I wear this dripping necklace that drips all the way down here. The following day I wear necklace that says baby girl. Next I wear necklace that says this. So towards the end of the month, I noticed that I had a lot of rashes. Patched hyperpigmentations on my neck. I'm like, first of all, this is winter season. I'm wearing coats. My neck is covered. So how is it that I'm having all these rashes? Okay, you know what's good? I'm going to actually go see a dermatologist. And guess what, you guys? I've actually been having allergic reaction to the dripping jewelry that I've been wearing. So literally, I had contact dermatitis and I thought it was like sunburn. And then they recommended me to be using this ointment, this vitamin E ointment. I think someone actually asked me on my Instagram story. It stops the entire itchy process. And I think it's actually been helping with clearing all the rashes, because all those rashes that were here are literally all gone. And hyperpigmentation is definitely getting a lot better. Peace of mind. I just wear choker just to be on the safe side. But anyways, too much of this talking and storytelling. If you guys leave me, I'm going to be gisting with you guys the entire day. So let's just get into my hair, okay? My hair, the hair I'm actually going to wear in today's video is from Ula Hair. This is what the wig looks like. It's a 14-inch curly wig. It's very springy. It's short bob. And then it's curly. I'm excited to see how this is going to turn out, actually. What it looks like straight out of the box is a lace front wig. It's also pre-plucked, which is perfect. I don't have to pluck anything at all. So I just go ahead to tint the lace just so it's a lot more like my actual skin tone. And to tint the lace, I'm using my Lancome foundation as my usual in the shade 510 Suede. Oh my god, you guys, wigs are so great for like last minute protective styles. I haven't done my hair since the last time I had that ponytail that I had in my last video, my last ponytail video. I haven't touched my hair since then because I've just been so sick, so weak, that I don't want to get up from the bed. I just want to be sleeping all day. My natural hair just be just like that. I've not been taking care of it lately. I'm going to use this Got To Be Free spray to actually, you know, seal down this lace front to my head. I don't know if it's just me or if anybody can actually relate to this, but I can't go to bed with a wig on my head. Like, no, the sleep is not even the same thing. I literally can't go to bed with a wig on. I don't know. I literally can't. I love the fact that this wig just fits so right. Like, it fits my head perfectly. I'll use my blow dryer right now to actually dry down this Got To Be Free spray, so that this wig can actually stay secure. I'm just going to go ahead to cut out the excess lace. I'll just go ahead to use this Red by Kiss elastic band. Spray some water on this hair. So I'll go ahead to use this brush as well to brush this hair. Wow, look at this. And I also want this curl to just stay like this in this wet look. So I'm actually going to go ahead to set it using this Curls Avocado Hair Mousse from the Green Tea Collection. Oh damn, I'm already running out. You guys, look at this hair and the curls. Oh, I think I should not worry. I'm going to leave the link, the details to everything in this video. Hair, skincare, makeup, outfits, everything is going to be down below in the description box, okay? I actually love this hair. I love the length. It's going to be perfect for this spring and summer season. You know, it's short. It's just really nice and convenient. Right, I'm actually running late, so I'm going to run through the makeup with you guys really, really fast. So starting off with this Obagi. I don't know if it's Obagi. I don't know if I'm saying it correctly. But this is a sunscreen with SPF 50. I was actually introduced to this sunscreen by Beauty by JJ Jenny Jenkins here on YouTube, one of the OG beauty gurus. I saw her using it in one of her videos, so I decided to give it a try. I bought mine on Amazon. Also, it's as a primer. It also gives me that mattifying look. It doesn't grease my face up, so it serves as a primer and as well as a sunscreen in one. I know you guys have seen me do my brows here so many times, so I went ahead to do that really quick off camera. So right now, I'm just going to go ahead to my eyeshadow. For my eyeshadow, I'm using the Modern Renaissance palette because I'm going for a spring pink, a pink spring makeup look. Let's start off using this orangey color right here. This one, Ryoga. And I'll just put that all over my eyelid space. And then you guys, I just remembered something. I'm going to be doing a wig giveaway very soon, sometime next month. I'll be giving away this wig that I know that a lot of you saw it on my channel and loved it so much. But a lot of people complain about the price of the wig. I'm pretty sure you guys know what I'm talking about. So if you know the wig I'm talking about, you can comment down below. I really love that wig actually because it's very different. It's just really nice and cute. It's just different. It's just my style. But I think I'll give it to one of you guys that will actually enjoy the hair and use it more frequently than I do. Because truth be told, I don't really wear my hair for that long, so most times I always end up changing my hairstyles. Sorry if I get distracted. So after doing the orange eyeshadow for like my entire eyelid space, I'm going to go ahead right now to use this red Autry. Is this really dark burgundy pink? I said pink. Is this really dark burgundy pinkish tone? This one right here. I'm going to use that for the corner of my eyes right here. Just this spot right here. If you know the wig I'm actually talking about, comment that down below. But that wig is actually so beautiful. It's literally one of my favorite wigs that I've ever owned. And it's just different. It's special. It's, everything about it is unique. But yeah, I'll be giving it away to one of you guys. And also be giving away clippings. Because I have a couple clippings from different brands. I love these clippings, but it's just like, I have more than one bundle. What am I doing more than one bundle when I could give it away to someone that will actually, you know, cherish it and appreciate it and use it frequently more than me? So I'm going to be giving away a clipping extension bundle, and I'll also be giving away the wig. So you guys should stay tuned for that giveaway. It's going to be international. Right now, I'm going to go ahead to cut my crease using my NYX Cosmetics eyeshadow base. That's looking really good. And then right now I'm going to go ahead to use this pinkish shimmery eyeshadow, and the color is Vermeer, this one right here, the top. Oof, that's so bright, right? I don't know, I feel like it's too bright, so I'll go ahead to tone it down a little bit using this bright pink right here from JVS Play's Zulu palette. And I'll just put that right on top of this one. Let's see if it's going to help. I think that's better. It's a lot more toned down right now. Yeah, there you go. So as you guys can see, I just put on my lashes real quick. Right now, I'm just going to go ahead and put on my foundation. And the foundation I'm going to be using is the usual one that I always use, which is the Cover FX Power Play Foundation in the shade N110. I think I'll be getting a darker shade of this foundation just for the upcoming summer season, because now I'm going to tan for sure. Use my damp beauty blender to blend it into my skin. For my forehead, I don't really like using like so much foundation, so I just put like a little bit. Sometimes I even use like the remnants of the foundation that I have on my beauty blender. That's it. I'm going to go ahead to use the LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Fun. And I'll use that to brighten underneath my eyes. There you go. Now to conceal my chin and my nose. To set my concealer, I'll go ahead to use my Fenty Beauty setting powder in the shade Honey. To my forehead. You guys, it's always important to actually set your concealer just so it doesn't crease, okay? For contour, I'm going to be using my Fenty Beauty contour stick in the shade Espresso. Now just use that right here. Alright, I'm going to apply some blush, and I'm using the ColourPop Super Shock Cheek Blush on my cheek. Then I'll just go ahead to set my face using my MAC Fix Plus Setting Spray. And apply some highlights. I'm using my Fenty Beauty highlighter in the shade Hustler Baby. Just tap that here. Remember to tap, okay? Tap, 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 tap. Get more pigment when you tap. Put some highlights on my nose as well. Oh shit. I'm just going to go back real quick to line my eyes and to finish up with the bottom part of my eyes as well. And I'm currently using like the ColourPop
black pencil eyeliner for this part. Back to this Modern Renaissance palette. And I'm going back to this burgundy color right here. This reddish, pinkish burgundy color that we use for like our outer crease corner of our eyes. I'll use that for... I'll use that for the bottom part of my eyes to balance like the entire eyeshadow look. Yep, this is perfect. So perfect. This, and this is the Benefit Cosmetics Badgal Bang Mascara. I'll use that for my bottom lashes as well. But you guys know I live for tear duct highlights. So I'm going to go back to this same shimmery pink that I use right here on my eyelid space. This one right here. And then mixing that tear duct highlight with the same pinkish color that I use for to tone down that shimmery color. I'm just going to do the exact same thing for this tear duct part as well. Brown lip liner. And I'll be using this makeup from Melanin Girls Cosmetics liquid lipstick in the shade Naked. Just a tiny bit. It's like a nudish peachy undertone. Just a little bit. And then now I'm going to use my Fenty Beauty Gloss Balm over top. I'm not really feeling this lip for this eye look, so I think I'll add a touch of pink to my lips as well. Using this this lip gloss, I got it from back home. It's pinkish. There you go. Well, yeah, so you guys, this is basically the end of this whole pink spring inspired look. Hair, everything, makeup, my outfits. This is basically the end of this video. If you did enjoy this video, please don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Also, please stay tuned for the giveaway I'll be having very soon for the wig and the clipping extension, and have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye. Mwah.
Lego. It's the original, 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 original Batman.
Original, 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 original.